Forces for Good, written by Leslie R. Crutchfield and Heather McLeod Grant, is a book about six practices of high-impact nonprofits. In this book summary, we will discover how the authors came up with the six practices, what the practices are, and quickly review some ways in which your nonprofit can adapt some of the practices noted. Now, without hesitation, let's begin our journey. The practices that are common across all of the 12 organizations identified by Crutchfield and Grant are that they advocate and serve, make markets work, inspire evangelists, nurture nonprofit networks, master the art of adaption, and share leadership. The authors also state that when a nonprofit applies all of these forces simultaneously, it creates the momentum that fuels further success. Organizing the framework. After Crutchfield and Grant identified the six practices, they began to see that each of them interacts with each other in a mutually enforcing way. The authors state that like a complex organism with interdependent components, the whole is greater than the sum of its parts. One example that was given by the authors is building a network of nonprofits and inspiring evangelists give organizations even more force to influence government policy and business practices. Through shared leadership, these organizations empower each other to act on their behalf. Through adaption, they remain relevant in an ever-changing environment. We will now take a closer look at each of the practices in order to better understand how they are able to make organizations more impactful. Please keep in mind how you personally would implement each of these practices in your own organization, and note the ways that each practice interacts with each other to produce impactful results. Once again, these six practices are advocate and learn, make markets work, inspire evangelists, nurture nonprofit networks, master the art of adaption, and share leadership. The author states, as we examine more closely how and why organizations engaged in both policy advocacy and direct service, we discover that simultaneously doing both creates a vicious cycle. Rather than causing the organization to lose focus or decreasing its impact, the two together can create impact that is greater than the sum of its parts. According to Crutchfield and Grant, the nonprofits that provide services create local solutions, which can then be used to inform their policy positions in government and business relationships. Nonprofits see firsthand what is working on a ground level and what is not working, which makes them the experts on populations they serve and/or the programs they run, which gives them the power to make real-life changes in the political and business worlds. The authors identified five common principles that each of the 12 organizations use to advocate successfully. These practices are: balance pragmatism with idealism, practice principled bipartisanships, preserve credibility and integrity, hire policy experience, find funding for advocacy. The 12 organizations that were studied found three distinct ways to work with and through businesses to achieve more social impact, according to Crutchfield and Grant. The organizations did not seek to act like a business so much as leverage the power of business. The three practices used in the 12 high-impact nonprofits to leverage businesses are change business practices to make companies more socially responsible, and by doing so, they change the entire industries in some cases. Partner with businesses, which can mean everything from accessing donations and volunteers to creating operational alliances. Run a business. Nonprofits serve markets by running their own business. For example, I'm the executive director of a nonprofit that has many social programs, but we are also running our own custodial and lawn care programs, which run as a business. Crutchfield and Grant discovered that the 12 high-impact nonprofits that were studied go beyond building a community among their internal staff and clients. they actively mobilize the public for greater social change. As the nonprofits grow, they continually expand their circle of support, individuals served, and influence in their communities. They steady create change makers. Crutchfield and Grant identified 4 rules of engagement to create evangelists for your nonprofit. Communicate your mission, vision, and values. Create meaningful experiences. Cultivate evangelists. And build a beloved community. What is a network? According to the authors, a network is a group of related things that work together to achieve a larger goal. Nurturing relationships and networking is important in order to become a high-impact nonprofit. Each of the 12 nonprofits studied tapped into the power of networks, generally sharing these 4 tactics. Grow the pie, share the knowledge, develop, and work in coalitions. Crutchfield and Grant state, "We believe that mastering the cycle of adaption is critical to success, precisely because they exist at the intersection between markets and governments, which are constantly changing. Successful nonprofits must continually adapt in order to remain relevant." The nonprofits that were studied discovered how to master adaption. They exhibit the ability to listen, innovate, learn, and modify their approach. Great nonprofit leaders share power, according to Crutchfield and Grant. There are several different types of leadership styles, but the power of collective leadership seems to be the most common leadership style shared among the 12 high-impact nonprofits. So, now that you know the 6 principles that make organizations high-impacting, how do you sustain success? Crutchfield and Grant recognize 3 critical elements needed to maintain and deepen their impact over time. People. Develop a people strategy and invest heavily in top performers. Capital. Find the right resources for funding. Infrastructure. Invest in overhead despite the pressure to always look lean. In summary, I appreciated the 6 principles identified as the common principles that the 12 high-impact organizations share. I would also say that it is not a one-size-fits-all path for all organizations to create a high-impact capacity. Some of the principles would be a challenge for organizations that do not have the budget, staff, or resources to implement these principles. However, these principles could be used in strategic planning as a benchmark or goal to help organizations work towards improvement. Thank you.